champion Jill Trenary of the United States in hot pursuit of Tonya Harding.
Well, the 15-year-old dynamo from Paris, France. And she is a thrill to watch, Misha.
Certainly is. This young lady is a great athlete, but at the same time, a somewhat inexperienced skater, having only skated 4.5 years and opening up with 2 double axels. A triple lunge. She had a little trouble in the warm-up earlier today. And she heads up to it into a double toe loop. That's exactly what I'm talking about, Phil. That ability to pull the jumps out, even though they're not perfect, that demonstrates her incredible athleticism.
Spin.
Look at the extension on her. You know, that's the thing. Even though there are certain parts of her skating that could become more mature, more polished, more finished, she still has this great strength, this great stamina. And possibly that comes from her past, her tumbling experience. She was a tumbler at one time, and in fact, even on the entrance to some of these jumps, as you'll see in a minute, she stands very erect in much the same way a tumbler would do so. Like there, into that triple toe loop. Another triple lutz. She elected to do a double. Skater can choose to do that.
Simply marvelous performance by 15-year-old Surya Bonaly of France.
5.2 to 5.5 for technical merit. I mean, that demonstrates that the judges did take note of the fact that she had successfully executed quite a number of triple jumps. And, of course, her scores in technical merit will be better than those for artistic impression. And there you see them, 4.9 to 5.3, and that's the maturity we're talking about.
West Germany, this is the tallest of the competitors, Marina Kielmann, as we join her midway through her freestyle program. Nicely done.
Particularly towards the end of a program, to do jumps off of one foot, landing on the same foot repeatedly is very difficult.
Working on a brand new routine, Marina Kielmann of Dortmund, Germany. Five. And in artistic impression, from 4.9 to 5.3. Up next, our national champion, Jill Trenery of Colorado Springs, Colorado. When he has learned from the best, coached by Carlo and Krista Fossey. Where the Olympic flame still burns brightly in the heart of Jill Trenery. Let's watch.
This program, Phil, is almost primordial yet elegant. And she is, throughout it, physical yet emotional. Opening triple toe loop. Oh, no! She was leaning forward too much and just didn't quite hit it. Very important next jump, a triple flip. Fell out of that a little bit as well. Standing in second place after the original program. Jill really has to skate well here to overtake Harding. And the double axel, again, leaning forward. Earlier today, she told us that this part of her program was the most difficult, from the double axel through to her triple toe loop sequence.
Pulls out and elects to do the double.
Let's see. Here it is. Well, she goes for it, but just doesn't quite hit it.
Now to the music, Chicas y Chicas.
Triple stop count. Doesn't even get that one. Oh. This is very unfortunate for Jill. Clearly is not her night. Point, the technique has to be there in order for the skater to feel confident.
The bronze medalist at the Worlds last March in Paris, France, Jill Trenery. She finished runner-up to both Claudia Leichner of Federal Republic of Germany and Japan's sensational Midori Ito. But on paper coming into this, as all of us do as well, her score is hovering right around between 5 up to 5.5.
Yeah, she's very lucky with that 5.5. Of course, as you know, technical merit rates, the relative difficulty of the program, the relative difficulty of jumps, spins, and the interconnecting steps.
And the second set of numbers, which Jill is awaiting, artistic impression, or how the judges feel she skated her particular routine.
That's right. And you can see 5.2s to 5.6 reflects the fact that the program was harmonious.
Confident.
19-year-old Tanya Harding, now of Portland, Oregon. What a dazzling display she put on in the short program, Misha.
That's exactly right, Phil. This young lady represents raw athletic ability. Sometimes it's not as always controlled, but she's got the ability. And watch the spring on this opening triple lutz. Look at the height! Herself into these jumps. Back a little bit more on these back crossovers, but that's the one thing she's lacking, the finesse. But watch the athletic ability. Triple flip. And again. Coming up to a very important move, the triple axel. Here she goes. She elects to do a single. She can choose to do that. It will not be reflected in the marks except to the extent that it reduces the technical difficulty of the program. Another successfully executed triple fill, and what she's doing here is what she has to do in order to maintain first place. Double axle is two of these jumps. Another double axle.
Breaks out into a broad grin as Tanya Harding knows she is going to hold on to the top spot.
She has indeed done it this time.
Terrific performance by the 19-year-old from Portland, Oregon. 3 years ago, she was runner-up here at Skate America to Tiffany Chan. And I think she has a chance here, Misha, at this point in the competition to perhaps take the gold away from Indianapolis.
I think she does indeed. That was just a terrific performance for Tanya. As we said, sometimes she throws herself into these jumps with
marks from 5.6 up to 5.8 from four judges.
Well, that exactly accurately reflects the technical difficulty of her program and the fact that she did execute all of her jumps successfully.
How well did she skate that difficult program? 5.6s, 5.7s. The Italian judge gives Tanya a 5.4.
Well, that's right. And, of course, that's the maturity we're talking about. The finesse, the completeness is not quite there yet.
Stoneham, Massachusetts.
Well, Nancy knows at this moment that she has a shot at moving into second place ahead of Jill, given what's happened to Jill Trenary.
Yeah, this young lady right here has a rather unusual blend of artistry, power, grace. She's very, very strong, Misha, but as we are about to see, appears almost effortless. Looks to almost glide about a half inch above the surface of that ice.
That's it. To do a double and into a double toe loop. She's kind of a wild card, Phil. You're never sure if she's actually going to execute these triples or not, but when she does them beautifully. Let's watch again. See if she does a triple flip. She tries. Again, that left free foot just didn't get out fast enough. She was leaning a little bit in the air. Right through that jump. Floated. She elects to do a double again. Unfortunately, I think that Nancy's shot at the silver medal is slipping away from her.
Can almost see it registering in her face.
She managed to hang on. She at least got that triple in. And at the end of her program, that should be some consolation to her.
He is 19 years old. He is Nancy Kerrigan, and remember that name. In third after the original program, and her scores here for technical merit in the freestyle hovering right around the 5-1, 5-2 area.
That's right, and you can see that the fact that she didn't execute more than one triple in this program elegantly had an effect on those technical merit marks. I would anticipate that her artistic impression would be a little bit higher.
5.1, 5.3. Our artistic impression, again, the numbers hovering right in the mid-fives, 5.2 up to 5.4. From the German Democratic Republic, this is Simone Lang.
Watch this double axel. Of course, this is a little bit reminiscent of Katarina Witt, those arm movements and that kind of footwork.
And that's certainly no accident because Simone is coached by Frau Jutta Mueller, who is Katarina's legendary coach and an outstanding figure skater in her own day.
Exactly right.
Well, how often in a coach's career, no matter what country you hail from, do you have a skater like a Katarina Witt?
Exactly. And that was one of only many whom Frau Mueller has had. Caught her toe on the entrance into that jump preparation.
Hey,
down. She elects to do a double. A few more years of tutelage under Frau Mueller, and I'm sure we'll see a much more consistent skater.
Stylish and well-executed performance by East Germany's Simone Lang.
Four, five,
technical
five,
merit
two,
for Simone
five,
Lang.
Five,
Japanese
five,
and Canadian two. Judges, along with the Italian judge at 5-2, ranging up to a 5-5 by the judge from the United States.
That's right, and of course, her program was a little bit more technically difficult than Nancy Kerrigan's, and you can see that reflected in the marks.
5.2. 5.5.
Artistic impression or the judge's interpretation of how well she skated her particular program. Again, the marks, I think, Misha, in line with what we saw.
That's right, 5-1 to
Japan.
5-2.
This is Junko Yaganuma, and she has a very sore right calf muscle.
Intends to open up with a triple Lutz jump. Let's see how that affects her. Well, just can't quite hold on to the landing. And remember, she's going to be landing on the right leg. That is her landing leg. So that injured calf muscle may be a factor.
This music sounds familiar. It is Chuck Mangione's rendition of Children of Sanchez.
She was practicing in the practice session. She was having an awful lot of difficulty landing these jumps, and I think already thus far in the program she's done a remarkable job. Here's a triple toe wally. She does hang on to that. This morning she was falling on those.
Of the ladies here in 1989.
I think it may be symptomatic of their desires and goals.
Well said.
Thank you. Well, Junko is clearly not a great technical skater.
Oh,
and you can see there again that double axel. She has a problem as she steps into it. Almost every one of them that she did in the program. And that created, finally, problems on the landing.
She is 16 years of age. Junko Yaganuma from Tokyo, Japan. Only her fourth seniors competition.
5.2.
Junko Yaganuma, technical merit. Score is 5-1 up to 5-5.
Well, you can see again there the reflection there in the judges' marks that she just simply didn't have the technical content that, for example, Tanya Harding had in her program. And again, on the artistic side, we would anticipate not seeing such high marks again. 5-1 to 5-5. Requires a little more finesse and experience in the international arena.
Now coming into the screen, has won the gold.
And the reigning national champion, Jill Trenary, was only able to capture a silver medal after a disappointing performance. And Simone Lang of East Germany, hoping to be the heir apparent to Katarina Witt, got the bronze.
A rather poignant ending to a great day of singles competition as a 19-year-old by the name of Tanya Harding from Portland, Oregon, successfully slayed the lion.
Phil and Schwartz and Krennic did all of their elements.
Here skating, these are the pairs from Canada, Michelle Menzies and Kevin Wheeler.
They start out with a split double twist lift. Very exciting in the rehearsals here, Phil. They were doing a lot of big throws, and everybody was really excited about the throws, so we'll watch for them. Double axles side by side.
Relatively new, Judy, to the international scene. They finished fourth earlier this year in their Canadian Nationals, but a very exciting young couple to watch.
Yes, they are. They're very good at the single jumps, the solo jumps, and also at the throws. As you can see, a beautiful throw triple salchow.
Freestyle competition tonight.
Very nice position on a pair spin. There's so many elements in pair skating. They have to do the single jumps together. They have to do lifts, throws, the spins together, the spins apart. And it's very difficult to go back and forth between being a soloist, an individual skater, and a team.
Not to mention trying to keep those four blades from interacting with one another as you're skating across that sheet of ice.
It's very difficult. do.
Sequence there on the side-by-side sit spins.
That's right. It's not as important here on the long program as it is in the original program. However, it's still very important. The unison is there. Very dangerous upside-down lift.
Their performance here in Skate America 89. Michelle Menzies with scores ranging from 5-3 and Judy very, very consistent up to 5-4, and I think that is certainly reflective of the performance we just witnessed.
Yes, well, they're the first skaters. These are a little bit low, I think, for their technical
judges
behavior.
Again, very, very consistent 5-3s and 5-4s.
The next pair representing the United States of America.
They are sixth after the original program from the United States. Here is Karen Cortland and David Goodman.
First international competition, Phil, and they really had trouble recovering from that. But now on the step through, they're back on track.
Judy, realistically, how long does it take a pairs team to begin to gel as a unit?
I think it's a constant work to get to that. It's very difficult to be apart and then to find each other again and to maintain that power and energy that one must have no matter how far apart you get as a team. Program for them. If you see Karen off of the ice, she's exciting, she's fun, she's full of wonder. I saw her at the hotel looking around at all the different people and just enjoying the whole thing, and yet they've chosen this extremely dramatic performance. It's a totally new look from Karen Cortland off of the ice to Karen Cortland on the ice. Beautiful throw double axel. Unless we were really looking for her to put the hand down. he's a very tall guy and a beautiful dismount with the twist.
The 1812 Overture by Tchaikovsky. The pairs team of Karen Cortland and David Goodman. Oh, with David looking on there. Scores for technical merit ranging all the way from 4-6 up to 5-1.
Look at their height difference, Phil. You can see how it would be a problem to match and to have in unison. And they did have some problems, which we'll probably see reflected in these marks.
Now, you're absolutely right, Judy. And certainly those... those inconsistencies.
Our next skaters representing Canada, Stacy Ball and Jean-Michel Bombardier.
They have been together 2 months from Canada. This is Stacy Ball and Jean-Michel Bombardier. Can you imagine, Judy, the tension and pressure this young pair's team must feel?
After just 2 months together, just learning to skate together in 2 months is incredible. Big double axel throw. But you know also, what have they got to lose? They were invited to an international competition, their second month of skating together. If they come here and wow these international judges, that will just start them on a wonderful career. They're doing well so far. Double toe loop. If you find just the right partner, I can't predict anything, but there seems to be a magic between this team. I thought last night when they ended up fourth in the original program that maybe it was a fluke. Maybe they were just excited by their first international competition. But they're really holding their own out here. They look terrific.
Thank you.
it's the coming back together that is perhaps the most critical, trying to get the hand positions to lock up.
Absolutely. That's very difficult to know exactly where that partner is. But it's also difficult, Phil, to prepare emotionally. It's two people that are preparing for an international competition. And the nerves and the stress happen in different ways on the team. That's hard on the coach also to try to figure what to say to them as they go out on the ice.
They train in Montreal. Scores for technical merit ranging from 5-1 all the way to 5-5. The judge from Great Britain. They have to be awfully particular program. From 5-1s to 5-4s. Representing the Soviet Union, Natalia Mishkuchenok and Artur Dmitriev. They are number one after the original program, and they are the defending champions of Skate America.
They will get credit for trying it. Oh, and a beautiful throw triple toe loop. Very, very seldom seen. It's an interesting takeoff. The unison. We're really looking at a team that is a class above. They move so beautifully across the ice. They're so fluid, and they're able to have fun while they're skating, and I think that you'll see the audience will pick up on that. Double axles side by side. She's in a beautiful position, a very simple lift. You don't see the simple lift so much anymore. I don't mean it was easy, just a simple line. And a throw triple Salchow.
Well, you're seeing an example here, Judy, of what split-second timing is all about in pair skating. It is critical to this regimen.
It certainly is. Not only the timing, a lot of the lifting is not. Oh, look at that, how he threw her back there. Beautiful dismount. The lifting is not always done simply with pure strength. It also is timing. Very important. uses her flexibility so well in this program. The choreography is truly suited to this team because they do unusual things. Look at that death spiral.
Interesting story. Dimitri grew up near the Arctic Circle. Natalia grew up in the Ukraine, and they were really brought to Leningrad as single skaters to be coached by Tamara Moskovina. Kuchonik and Arturo Dimitriev. What an electrifying routine. And Judy, I will be very, very surprised if their marks for technical merit ranging from 5.5 to 5.7. From the United States, here is Christy Yamaguchi and Rudy Galindo.
Of a throw lift into a throw Salchow. That's interesting creativity in their choreography. I think we're seeing more of that with Rudy and Christy. They're really putting more into the program as far as following one move with another, which adds to the difficulty.
Separate momentarily.
They are very good at that. They really work well together. And it's incredible the technical moves that they do, as the big jumps, the big triple jumps that they do. It's incredible. It's a great look.
Now, Christy is also an accomplished single skater. She is the reigning junior world champion. And while she skates singles, Rudy pretty much goes home to San Jose and works on his single jumps.
Oh, a nice girl. That's right, he does. But we can see that his work is paying off. He has to keep up with her strengths. She's working and training in single skating also. So it's really probably a good idea to have some of that. I think the hard part then would be the teamwork, but they're doing beautifully with it. They seem to be handling all the pressure of both events.
Thank you.
with the death spiral. Beautiful drag along the ice. Incredible strength and security on Rudy's part to be able to hold that and then turn it into a death spiral. Now watch. You see they're spinning opposite. You seldom see that. I think it's a wonderful look. It's very hard to do. And then separate into a jump. That power that is between them, the energy to be able to go apart, come back, and still maintain the energy. Listen to the audience.
Magnificent. Merit marks ranging from 5.5 all the way up to 5.8. By far the best scores we have seen in the pairs competition.
5.4 to 5.8, right in the right area.
Republic, Peggy Schwartz and Alexander Koenig.
A clean program. This is the team that Rudy and Christy have to beat tonight, and of course they've done that beautiful, perfect program. Still, they're really skating very quickly. Good power out of each step and into a beautiful overhead lift with a nice dismount. Go double axel.
Changes. But that was really a major problem. They really have to have a perfect program. You know, Phil, one of the important things about having an international competition in the United States is that our skaters are seen by the international judges on their own home ground. And I think that that showed tonight in Rudy and Christy. This audience was ready for them to be terrific, and they performed for them. In this case, we're seeing a beautiful performance, and they're doing all the technical moves, but it's just not that magical.
That's well said. And Skate America is certainly the premier international competition held here in the United States. Republic, Peggy Schwartz.